Harper Paperbacks and Harper Audio present We Love to Entertain, a novel by Sarah Strohmeyer, performed by Vivienne Leheny, Caitlin Davies, Megan Tusing, and Jamie Renell. For David and Dorinda Crowell, who were there at the beginning. All houses wherein men have lived and died are haunted houses. From Haunted Houses, by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, 1807 to 1882. Prologue.
I'm so sorry, Mom.
The apology is spoken in a whisper, somewhere between a prayer and a sob uttered into a dark, cold void. She is alone, forgotten, left to die. Her most feared childhood nightmare of being buried alive actually happening. There's no point in shouting. She's already tried that, of course. She yelled and begged when he walked away, when he climbed the makeshift ladder and dragged the rough piece of plywood over the hole. She screamed as he laid the heavy rocks one after the other, thunk, 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 in rhythm to her panicked heartbeat. She'd screamed and screamed until, already exhausted, she collapsed, her throat dry as the dust beneath her feet. He would not return. That was clear. Was that yesterday? This morning? 3 days ago? Impossible to tell here in this windowless cave. In the dimming light of the lamp, she can make out desiccated potatoes, rotted, dried, and darkened to black lumps scattered here and there on the dirt floor. The air is dank and thick. Oxygen is running low. It smells of urine and vomit. Hers. No one will look for her here. If they even realize she's been abducted, which is doubtful. Her captor will have fooled them with artful lies. She went on the lam to save her own hide. She is not who she appears to be. She's cunning, ambitious, greedy, and now look what she's done, what misery she's caused. Good riddance to bad rubbish, they'll all say. Except her mother. She will keep on searching, never giving up until her daughter is found. Though by then, it will likely be too late.
It's on TMB. Behind the scenes of To the Manor Build with contestants Robert Barron and Holly Simmons. Lights, cameras, reveal. We can't believe the big day is almost here. After weeks of sweating contractor delays, faulty electrical wiring, disgusting black mold, emergency asbestos remediation, and gulp, a snake infestation, the three couples facing off in an epic competition on To the Manor Build are about to show the world their fabulous rehabs. And the stakes couldn't be higher. From design consulting to the last penny nail, TMB will cover 100% of the costs incurred by the lucky winning couple who, in a twist, won't be chosen by our experts, but by you. So log on to tothemanorbuild.com and get ready to cast your vote. The polls open online after the big reveal in just 2 weeks. While you're waiting in tense anticipation, we caught up with one of our star couples, Robert Barron and Holly Simmons, for a Q&A on some behind-the-scenes details and, oh my, are those wedding bells we hear? TMB. Thank you so much for taking a break from your super busy schedule this week as we get down to the wire. How are you handling the final crush?
Robert, thanks for having us. You know, the truth is, Holly's borne the brunt of this rehab, starting with the original vision, lining up the contractors, and making decisions every 5 minutes. I just stand around looking pretty.
Holly, that's not true. I saw you swing a hammer once.
Robert, must have been your secret lover. You know how I hate to ruin my manicure.
Holly, that's actually kind of true.
TMB, see, this is why you guys are fast becoming the fan favorites. Everyone loves your banter and obvious genuine mutual affection. Why don't you tell those new to TMB how you met?
Robert, not much to tell. Holly saw my bodacious bod on Tinder and swiped right.
Holly, don't believe a word out of this man's mouth. He is a congenital liar. The truth is, in my other existence, I run a real estate vlog, and I'd been following Robert's alternate persona as the robber baron for years. I was really impressed by his creative approach to real estate investing, but I told him he needed a better platform to showcase his properties other than a subscription newsletter. In that way, he's kind of an unfrozen caveman.
Robert.
Grunt.
Holly. Then, out of the blue, he called me last winter and asked if I wanted to go skiing in Vermont and check out this kooky property he'd recently acquired for a song at a tax sale. Thought maybe I might be interested in making a video of it.
Robert. Yeah, that was BS. I didn't care about the video. I only wanted the girl.
Holly. I'll admit, I had my doubts. All I knew about Vermont was it was cold and snowy and short on retail. Not exactly this southern girl's dream destination. But as soon as I saw the potential house site and the apple orchard and mountain views on 80 fabulous acres, I was in love.
Robert, to be clear, not with me, the property.
Holly. Then Robert told me about his plans for a net zero spec house. I knew immediately this was the perfect project for To the Manor build.
TMB. Who had the idea to submit a test tape to TMB? I bet it was you, Holly.
Holly. Guilty as charged. Robert was on the fence, but I was determined.
Robert. Technically, it wasn't just the fence I was on.
Holly, slapping him playfully. While we were filming, Robert and I discovered we share a commitment to saving the environment and thwarting climate change. I do everything in my ability to reduce my carbon footprint whenever I can. Grocery shopping at local farm stands.
Robert, my personal sacrifice is driving a Tesla.
Holly, rolling her eyes. Anyway, there's so much exciting, cutting-edge stuff happening now in environmental construction. We're so glad TMB was on board with that too and chose our rebuild to help bring our passion to light.
TMB. Actually, we were floored by your sizzle. Note, that's reality show lingo for the infamous test tape. We absolutely loved your design concept and your on-air chemistry, and judging from the chatter on Reddit's To the Manor Build subreddit, so do your fans. The question is, how do you think you'll fare against the competition? They've both got pretty moving backstories.
Holly. And we couldn't love them more, honestly. We are Joel and Sean's biggest cheerleaders.
TMB. They're the couple building a therapeutic ranch in New Mexico for LGBTQ2+ teens who've been bullied at school or cast out by their families.
Holly. Besides championing a noble cause that's near and dear to my heart, from what we've been allowed to see of their design, I am floored. All those bright southwestern colors and the horses and the bridal path, I mean, where do I sign up?
Robert, we're gonna lose, aren't we? Ah, it's okay. Good run while it lasted.
TMB. And then, on the other side of the country in South Carolina, you have Drs. Sam Chidubham and Conchita Jimenez, who are establishing a seaside retreat for healthcare professionals and their families who sacrificed so much during the pandemic. Extremely inspiring.
Robert. Yep. We definitely are gonna lose.
Holly. First of all, hats off to anyone who worked in the medical field during the pandemic. I cannot even imagine the trials they endured. Secondly, I've been following Dr. Conchita's blogs online, and she and her husband embrace such a soothing aesthetic. Lots of tranquil pastels and sand tones. I am dying to swing in one of their rope hammocks overlooking the beach and watch my troubles disappear.
Robert, I agree with everything Holly just said.
Holly, for once.
Robert. All kidding aside, while both of these are incredibly worthy projects, they represent the present, while in my humble opinion, I like to think we represent the future.
TMB. Interesting. How so?
Robert. Our rebuild reflects a whole new way of approaching home construction in the era of climate change, We've employed the most advanced environmental technology, thick concrete walls, heat pumps that rely on geothermal energy, a peaked rubber roof that insulates and doesn't need to be replaced nearly as often, and yet is sturdy enough for a solar array. We're going to generate so much power from the sun, even in chilly Vermont, the local power company will have to buy the excess from us. Think about that.
Holly, he's right. Fingers crossed that viewers will be amazed at the reveal to learn they can live in a spectacular, energy-efficient house that's also stylish and able to be heated by a candle. Even, like Robert just said, in frigid Vermont.
Robert, upfront costs are made up by massive energy savings down the road. There's your future, folks.
TMB, speaking of future, as if you two don't have enough to do, you're squeezing in a spontaneous wedding soon.
Holly, clearly blushing. You know, Robert and I didn't want to make a big deal of it, but instead of spending the final week stressing over the TMB contest, on the spur of the moment, we decided, what the heck? Autumn's a magnificent season for an outdoor ceremony here in Vermont. The trees are absolutely on fire.
Robert, we're thinking of doing a flash wedding, so keep checking the website for the pop-up live stream, just in case anyone's interested in seeing me in a skirt. I mean, kilt. I do have extremely attractive knees, if I do say so myself. Show 'em the ring, darling.
Holly, displaying a halo engagement ring of blue and ice-white diamonds in a platinum setting. Robert designed this himself. It's ethically sourced, by the way. The platinum is recycled.
Robert, the center diamond is lab-grown, which means it's only slightly less expensive than a normal 2-carat would be if it were mined by oppressed children in a third-world country. And yet I've been assured by the jeweler it'll retain its value long after death do us part.
Holly. Oh, baby, don't even say that.
Robert, leaning down for a kiss. I swear, nothing can part us, sweetheart. Not even death.
TMB. Aw, who doesn't love lovers in love? We at TMB wish you all the very best. And to all of you on Team H&R, do keep checking the site for your personal digital invites to Holly and Robert's flash wedding that could happen any day now. You don't want to miss a moment of romance.
Robert, not to mention my knees.
1. Erika. Saturday. On the morning of the wedding, Erika Turnbull plugs an AirPod into her right ear, syncs it with her iPhone, and grabs her pink metal travel mug of coffee with 3 splashes of half and half. The day's schedule printed and secured in a plastic page protector, she exits her tiny studio apartment at the top of her mother's garage, locks her door, and jiggles the handle twice to make sure it's secure. Call her superstitious, but with so much on the line, she's not taking any chances. Nothing can go wrong today. Absolutely nothing. And if anything does, if Robert's Cuban cigars aren't delivered, or the caterers forget to swirl the figs in chèvre with the small-batch balsamic vinaigrette she specifically ordered from a farm in Modena, if the blue skies cloud and rain falls right as the couple are exchanging vows, then yes, fingers will point toward her. All part and parcel of being an assistant. None of the credit, and all of the blame. No problem, she thinks, trying to summon more confidence than she actually feels. If only she had more experience being in front of the cameras. She's been working for Holly and Robert less than a year, and always behind the scenes doing what assistants do on these home remodeling shows. Nagging vendors, checking orders, updating calendars, running to the hardware store for paint and extension cords, or to the general store for sandwiches and coffee to sustain the crew. In other words, executing the many mundane tasks that keep the boat afloat. This wedding will be the polar opposite. She will be Holly's only bridesmaid, the first one to walk down the grassy aisle and the center of attention for 3 excruciating minutes. Thousands of fans are predicted to tune in, perhaps hundreds of thousands, and the ceremony will be recorded, which means any faux pas will be instantly uploaded online, where it will permanently reside to humiliate her forever. The prospect makes her almost physically ill, since unlike her photogenic employers, Erika isn't one for basking in the limelight. In fact, she's gone out of her way to avoid being in the public gaze. She has her reasons. Valid ones. Not that they're of any importance today. Hey, at least the weather's nice, she thinks. Clear and warm for mid-October.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.